In the previous video, we have seen how to calculate the time average power density in different types of media, including dielectric media, lossy dielectric media, and conducting media. And we have seen that the time average of Poynting vector inside a conducting media is given by 1 over 4 multiplied by the conductivity of the media, multiplied by the skin depth delta, multiplied by the amplitude of Ex naught at the starting point of the medium, multiplied by e to the power minus 2 z over delta. And it can be noted that in this case, the time average power density is decaying exponentially with a factor e to the power minus 2 z over delta. So at a large z, the total power density would be nearly zero. So in this case, it means that if we have, for example, a sample of a conducting media like this, and this sample extends in y direction from 0 to b, and in x direction from 0 to l, and extend along the z direction from 0 to infinity, and there is an incident electromagnetic waves coming from the negative half space to this conducting slab. So the power density at the interface between the free space and the conducting media, it can be calculated by setting the value of z to be 0 and integrating the power density over the surface area. So the power in this case would be the integration from 0 to b, the integration from 0 to l, 0 to b it would be dy, 0 to l would be dx, multiplied by the Poynting vector or the power density or the average power density, which is 1 over 4 sigma delta Ex naught square e to the power minus 2z over delta at z equal 0. Effectively, the Poynting vector in this case is in z direction and the surface area in z direction. So z dot ds, sz dot ds would be in the same direction. So the dot product would be just the multiplication. So this is the total total power density. This is the total power at the surface of the interface. The total power at the surface of the interface. And because the power density inside the conducting media is decaying exponentially to reach zero, it means that all the power enters the interface will be lost, or there will be losses inside this conducting media. So assuming that this conducting media or this slab is extending to infinite z, so at z equal infinity, we have total average power density equal zero. So it means that all the power that entered at the interface had been lost inside this conducting slab. So the power losses equal the power at the interface, which equals the integration of the power density over the surface area, which correspond to the surface area that enters the power. So by taking the integration, here this is a constant function with respect to x. So the integration with respect to x would be x, and the limit would be from 0 to l, it would be just l. And the integration with respect to y is also constant with respect to y. So it would be y, and the limits would be from 0 to b, so it would be b. So in this case, the total power enters this conducting material, and the total power which is lost inside this conducting material is 1 over 4 multiplied by sigma multiplied by delta multiplied by b multiplied by l multiplied by Ex naught square. Okay? We are going to define the surface current density Jx naught as the sigma, the conductivity of the material multiplied by E x naught. So effectively J x naught, if we are looking at the direction of the electric field, the direction of the electric field in x direction. And because this is a conducting material, so there would be a current density inside this material. And the current density at the interface would be sigma multiplied by the electric field. So, and the direction of this current would be in the same direction of the electric field. So the current density Gx naught, the current at the interface, equals the conductivity of the medium multiplied by Ex naught. So we are going to replace sigma multiplied by Ex naught by Gx naught. But already we have only one sigma. So we will multiply by another sigma and divide by a sigma. So in this case, sigma squared Ex naught squared can be replaced as Gx squared. And we have a new sigma in the denominator. So power losses in terms of the surface current density at the interface between free space and the conducting media is given by 1 over 4 sigma multiplied by delta, which is the skim depth, B is the length of the metallic strip, L is the width of the metallic strip, so multiplied by Gx naught squared. Gx naught squared is the surface current density at the interface. Okay? So this is the power losses inside this conducting media. And we say that this power losses because this power density is going to be decaying such that it will die completely after a while. So all the power which enters this conducting material would be lost inside this conducting material. So the power losses inside this conducting strip equals 1 over 4 sigma multiplied by delta BL Gx naught squared. Our plan is to derive an equivalent resistance for this metallic strip such that we are going to plan to say that the power losses is half I squared R, where R is the equivalent AC resistance of this metallic strip. So what we are going to do now is to derive an equivalent resistance for this structure. And to derive this equivalent resistance, it is required to derive the equivalent current density in a simple strip from this conducting material. So what we are going to do now, what is the total current passing through this conducting medium? The total current passing through this conducting media, it can be represented as the current density J multiplied by the surface area of this conducting medium. And effectively J is due to the electric field Ex. So as long as we have electric field in X direction, we have current density J. So assume that this metallic strip, as it is between two potential, positive and negative, from these two sides, and we have current in this case, but this positive and negative is decaying. So to obtain the total current, we are going to say that the total current passing through this conducting strip or this conducting plane equal the current density J, Gx, multiplied by the cross-section area of this strip. The cross-section area of this strip, in this case, it is dy, dz. And the limit of dy is from 0 to b, and dz from 0 to infinity. So the total current passing through all this metallic strip equal Gx multiplied by d surface, which is dy multiplied by dz. Okay? And the limit of dy is from 0 to b, and the limit of dz is from 0 to infinity. And the current jx equals the conductivity multiplied by the value of ex. Now it is not ex as the interface, it is ex as a function of z. So ex here is not just the function or ex naught. So in this case, ex here, gx, it would be the value of ex. Unfortunately, ex in the previous video. Ex is actually ex naught multiplied by e to the power minus alpha z. Okay? So, the magnitude or the value of gx at any value of z equal the value of gx at the interface, which is gx naught, multiplied by the attenuation coefficient e to the power minus alpha z, which is e to the power minus z over delta, multiplied by the wave function cosine omega t minus beta z. This is effectively the value of gx at any value of z, which is so simply sigma multiplied by ex. Okay? Alright. So, in this case, the phasor quantity of gx can be represented as gx naught multiplied by e to the power minus alpha z, which is e to the power minus z over delta, multiplied by e to the power minus jz over delta, or in other words, minus j beta z, and beta is 1 over delta. So this is the phasor form of this instantaneous form. Okay, now we already have the current j as a function of z. We can replace this j by this integration. So the total current, this is current density. So we are going to replace this current density by this. So the total current would be the current density gx naught multiplied by e to the power minus z over delta, e to the power minus z over delta, multiplied by e to the power minus jz over delta, multiplied by e to the power minus jz over delta. This would be integrated over the surface area, the cross-section area of this metallic strip, which is dy from 0 to b, dz from 0 to infinity. Fortunately, because this is decaying function with respect to z, if we are going to apply z by infinity, it would be 0. So, in this case, the integration with respect to y would be constant, so it would be b. And the integration with respect to z, it would be minus delta over 1 plus j multiplied by the exponential term, e to the power minus 1 plus j multiplied by z over delta. And the limit of integration with respect to z, it would be from 0 to infinity. So by applying infinity, this term would be 0. By applying 0, this term would be unity, 1. So 0 minus 1 would be minus 1. Minus minus would be plus. So the total surface current passing from this side to this side along all this strip would be gx naught multiplied by b multiplied by the skin depth delta over 1 plus j. This is the phasor current. It can be represented as an amplitude and phase, as by taking the amplitude of 1 or plus j, it is the square root of the real part plus the imaginary part. Real part squared plus imaginary part squared, 1 plus 1, so it is square root of 2, and the angle here is 45 degrees or pi over 4, and because it is in the denominator, it would be in the numerator minus pi over 4. So as a phasor quantity, it is gx naught b delta over square root 2 with an angle minus pi over 4. as instantaneous time domain form, it would be I, it would be j x naught b delta over square root 2 cosine omega t minus the angle, which is pi over 4. Okay, so this is the total current passing through this complete strip. Now, instead of saying that this total current is passing through all the strip, we are going to concentrate this current in only a part of this strip. So, instead of saying this current is distributed exponentially along the strip, we are going to say that it is distributed uniformly along just one skin depth. So, the equivalent current density, for a uniform current along the depth of only one skin depth, it would be the total current over the skin depth delta. So, if this current is distributed with uniform current density, J dash, through the cross section, such that 0 to 0 is less than y, along from 0 to b in the y direction, and from 0 to delta in z direction, so the current density in this case, the uniform current density, not the exponentially decaying, the equivalent uniform current density in this case, it would be I over delta. So I over delta, it is jx naught over square root 2. I'm talking about the cross section b multiplied by delta. So I over b multiplied by delta. So the current density would be jx naught over square root 2 cosine omega t minus pi over 4. So this is the equivalent current density, equivalent uniform current density distributed inside just a strip of width equal one skin depth, and it is along all the conducting layer, so it is from 0 to b in y direction and from z equal 0 to delta, and this uniform current density has the same total current of the total current which is exponentially decaying form. So from the point of view of current, this uniform current has the same effect of this exponential decaying current, because the total current in this case would be the same as the total current in this case. So this is the uniform current distribution, or the uniform density current distribution, which satisfies the same total current. So if this uniform density current distribution satisfies the same total current, it means that it will satisfy the same power losses. So by multiplying the current in just a single strip of length b and width delta with this uniform current distribution, which has the same current I, in the resistance of this part only, so I squared R, in this case, will be the total current I, jx naught squared, d squared, delta squared, over 2, cosine squared, omega t minus pi over 4, multiplied by the resistance of this bar. The resistance of this bar effectively can be obtained as 1 over sigma multiplied by the length along the current, which is L, which is the length in the y direction, over the cross section area. What is the cross section area here? B multiplied by delta. So this is the resistance of the strip of width one skin depth. Now, by multiplying I squared, the total current, with this resistance, we find out the power losses in this strip equals 1 over sigma, 1 over sigma L over B delta. We have B delta here, and we have B delta squared here. So B delta squared here with this B delta would be delta in the denominator, Jx squared, B delta squared, and B delta. So B delta Jx squared. I'm here. B delta L Jx squared over 2 sigma cosine squared omega t minus y over 4. So this is I squared multiplied by the resistance of a strip of width equal 1 skin depth. Okay? Alright. Now, let us take the average of these power losses with respect to the time. So, the average power losses in this case, this cosine squared omega t would be 1 half the integration of cosine squared from 0 to t dt over 1t, it would equal 1 half. So, 1 half multiplied by 1 half j x squared sigma b l delta, so it would be 1 over 4 sigma j x squared b l delta. Do you remember? This actually the power losses which we have obtained from the pointing vector at the interface. So it means that the power losses in a resistor or any resistance of a strip of width just 1 skin depth and having the total current inside this strip equals the same power losses inside all this conducting strip. So, in other words, we can replace the conducting strip by just a strip of width skin depth and say that the current is uniform inside this strip of this width 1 skin depth, and the power losses in this case it would be the current squared multiplied by the resistance of this strip, and by taking the average it would be half I squared R. So, from this derivation, we can prove that we can replace any conducting media by equivalent AC resistance, and this AC resistance equal the resistance of a shell or a strip of the width of 1 skin depth. That's what we are seeing. The equivalent AC resistance, the average power losses in a conductor with skin effect present may be calculated by assuming that the total current is distributed uniformly in 1 skin depth. Now, in terms of the resistance, we may say that the resistance of width B and length A of infinite thick slab with skin effect is the same as the resistance of a rectangular slab of width B and length L and thickness equal delta, which is the skin depth, without a skin effect, or in other words, with uniform current distribution. As an example for this, assume that we have a copper wire of radius A, and this copper wire, it is required to find the equivalent DC resistance and the equivalent AC resistance at specific frequency. So, assuming that the radius of the wire A equals 1 millimeter and we have the length of the wire 1 kilometer, so the resistance in general equals the length of the wire over the conductivity multiplied by the cross-section area. But it depends which cross-section area. In the case of AC resistance, We are talking about the cross section of a strip of at the outer shell of this
wire.
So the cross section area in this case is effectively 2 by A multiplied by the skin depth, which is this small shell. So the AC resistance in this case, it would be the length of the wire over the sigma multiplied by the resistance or the surface area of the shell only, as if the electromagnetic wave is located only inside the skin depth. So if we are talking about DC, in this case the surface area is the surface area of the cross section area all, so it would be pi a squared. So if I'm talking about the DC resistance, the length it would be 1 kilometer, 1000, over pi r squared multiplied by the conductivity. So the DC resistance in this case is 5.48 ohms. But in the case of the AC resistance, effectively the electromagnetic waves or the current is only in the outer shell. So the surface area which is used to carry the current is only 2 by A multiplied by the skin depth, 2 by A delta. So at a frequency 1 megahertz, the skin depth is 0.066 millimeters. So in this case, the resistance would be the length 10 to the power 3, which is 1 kilometer, over the cross section area 2 by A multiplied by the skin depth. 2 by A, 1 millimeter, skin depth 0.066 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 3 meter, multiplied by the conductivity of the meter. Can be noted that in this case, the resistance is 41.5 ohm. Why? Because effectively the current is not using all the cross-section area of the wire, use only the outer shell of the wire. So this is the AC resistance and this is the DC resistance. Effectively, in calculating the losses in transmission line, in antennas, in waveguides and all of this, we are using the AC resistance, which is based on only the skin depth inside the material. And more than the skin depth, we are assuming that there is no electric field or no magnetic field or no current inside the conductivity. All right. Hopefully it is clear. All right.